Are you setting the air pressure on your air compressor correctly before you start airbrushing? Believe it or not, incorrectly setting your air pressure prior to beginning airbrushing is actually a relatively common problem that I see. It's more so with the folks that are just beginning to learn how to airbrush. So I thought I'd throw a video together and show you guys how to do it correctly. Depending on the compressor that you're using, you will see either one or two gauges on your compressor. If you're using one of the very small, compact, designed for airbrush only compressors, you'll probably only see one. If your compressor has an external tank, you may or may not see a second regulator gauge. So I've got my compressor here, and you can see I've got two gauges. The bottom one here goes to the tank. That shows how much pressure is in the tank. I don't need to worry about adjusting that at all. To adjust your air pressure, you want to find your regulator, and you can find that gauge because it'll have a knob like this somewhere around it. That's how you set the air pressure on your compressor before you begin airbrushing. So my compressor is completely dry. I'm going to go ahead and turn it on so that you can see both these gauges move as it begins to fill the tank. I've sped this up because there's no reason for you guys to sit and watch 4 minutes of video just showing my compressor as it fills up. But what I want you to pay attention to is the two gauges. The one on the top, again, is the regulator. That's where I adjust the air pressure for my airbrush. The one on the bottom is showing how much pressure is in the tank. So the regulator gauge on the top will stop at whatever pressure I have the air compressor set to. The one on the bottom will stop once the tank is full. So my tank is now full, and you can see it's got approximately 110 pounds of pressure in it, and my regulator is currently set at about 60, maybe slightly above 60 pounds. So in order to adjust your air pressure, you need to find your knob again, and this locks. So in order to unlock it, you'll pull it straight up, and then you can turn the knob either counterclockwise or clockwise. Counterclockwise will drop the air pressure, and clockwise will raise the air pressure. I'm generally spraying somewhere in the ballpark of between 20 and 30 PSI. So I want to turn it counterclockwise, and you can see the needle dropping down, and I'll put it about 25 PSI. Push it down to lock it. So currently, the regulator is set at 25 PSI. But is that really where it's set? It's a yes and no answer. Yes, it's set at 25 PSI currently. However, there's no draw on the system. I'm not taking any air out of the tank, and the compressor is not having to replenish that air. Once you begin using it, you'll see that your pressure is actually set at lower than 25 PSI. So let me grab my airbrush, watch the gauge, and what happens as I depress the trigger and activate the air on the airbrush. That's a pretty significant drop. Ordinarily, it won't drop quite that drastic. The reason it dropped that drastic for mine is because my compressor was completely dry, the hose, everything was 100% completely dry when I started. If you're starting with, say you used your airbrush yesterday, and then you set it to a different PSI setting, it will drop maybe 3 to 5 pounds. It won't drop quite that drastically. So the takeaway from all this is you need to set your air pressure with the air running on your airbrush. So let's depress the trigger on the airbrush, unlock the knob on your regulator, and I'm going to turn it clockwise to raise the pressure. Back up to 25 PSI, lock that back down. So now let's watch the gauge when I press the trigger. It's pretty much staying right at 25 PSI now. It actually raises slightly above that when I let off the trigger. That's how you correctly set the air pressure before you begin airbrushing. That seems very simple, I know, but like I said, surprisingly, there's a lot of folks, mostly when they're starting out, that just don't know any better, that actually get that wrong. So if you're having issues with your airbrush not spraying correctly, make sure that you've got your regulator set to the air pressure that you want to use it at. Hope you guys got something out of this. Remember to like, subscribe, and share if you did. I'll see you guys next time.